British chip designer, Arm, which licenses its chip core architecture to companies such as Qualcomm and Samsung, to make chips based on those core design has now announced its new CPU and GPU designs that will power next year's flagship chipsets from Samsung and Qualcomm. The most exciting thing about this new announcement is that Arm's core architecture is getting a major upgrade for the first time in a decade. The Arm V8 architecture that's been seen in pretty much every Android chipset over the last 10 years is being replaced by Arm V9, which brings with it more powerful and efficient processor cores. First up, we have the Arm Cortex-X2 CPU, which succeeds last year's Cortex-X1 processing core. The X1 was part of the Cortex-X Custom Program, which aims to help companies to create differentiated and customized products for their specific use cases. It takes a performance-first approach. Instead of pursuing a balance of performance, power, and area, the constraints that somewhat restrict the Cortex-A cores. The new Cortex-X2 core promises to deliver 16% higher performance compared to the X1 core, and twice as fast machine learning performance. Next is the company's first Arm V9 big CPU, the Cortex-A710. The mid-tier CPU promises 10% better performance and 30% improved efficiency, compared to the Cortex-A78, which it is intended to replace in future chip designs. Arm has also launched a new little high-efficiency core, the Cortex-A510, which delivers 35% faster performance and up to 20% better efficiency than the A55 that was revealed 4 years ago. The semiconductor firm claims that it's about as good as older big cores, which makes it ideal for affordable smartphones and wearable devices. The big little processor architecture implemented on flagship chipsets like Exynos 2100 and Snapdragon 888 allows smartphones to simultaneously and efficiently carry out high-intensity and low-intensity tasks. The big Cortex-A cores provide higher levels of performance within the thermal design boundaries, while the little cores are for executing background tasks without using a lot of power. The new V9-based chips with a tri-cluster CPU configuration, that is with a single Cortex-X2 core, 3 Cortex-A710 cores and 4 Cortex-A510 cores should be about 30% faster than the current top-performing Android flagships chipsets such as the Snapdragon 888. Arm has also introduced 3 new GPUs, the flagship Mali G710 promising up to 20% better gaming performance over the Mali G78 found inside the Galaxy S21's Exynos variant. It's accompanied by a less costly but similar GPU called the Mali G610. Then we have the Mali G510, which is meant for mid-tier phones and offers a 100% speed boost and 22% power efficiency gains. The company has also introduced the Mali G510 graphics core, which brings the Valhalla architecture to entry-level phones and wearables. However, the way Samsung has been teasing things this year, the Korean giant could switch to an AMD GPU for its next flagship Exynos chip. Rumors suggest the Samsung and AMD partnership will first bear fruit with a laptop later this year, and while there is no guarantee that Samsung will have an AMD GPU ready for its phones by 2022, it is looking highly likely given how long the two companies seem to have been working together. Even if the AMD GPU isn't ready by 2022, we should see faster performance and better efficiency on Samsung's flagship phones, thanks to the new Arm CPU and GPU designs that are bound to be used in Samsung and Qualcomm's next generation chips. So guys, that's pretty much we have here for now. We would love to know your thoughts on this. Hope you enjoyed the video and found it informative, and if you did, hit the like button and stay subscribed for more.